And then we need to share. Copy.
Interesting, if I'm on your channel, I don't get, doesn't like pop up and tell me you're live, like Facebook does.
Huh. That's a bummer. Right?
Like that seems dumb to me.
Yeah. Oh, our snail picture is very cute. Bye, Matt. Thank you. We're rolling. I got so much stuff in front of me. I couldn't make decisions, basically, is what it came down to. And I need to grab some water because I'm going to keep trying to drink my soap water. Which is not good. Welcome, everyone. I'm sacrificing the top of my head for more surface area. Just getting some water. So far, Kyla?
It's been good. You know,
yeah.
Day pretty much like yesterday,
yep.
Which was a lot like the day before.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Joyce says, do not drink the soap water.
No, that would be bad. It's always fun to see where everybody's from.
Austria.
Is Washington State ever not rainy?
I know. I don't know. I would like to go there. I hope this turns out to be fun. I think it's fun. I did a few things a little bit rushed and impatiently, which sometimes is my
wet-felting
MO. But today with you guys, I'm going to try and take my time. And we have time. It does not take long to lay these out and wet-felt them. So we can... we can slow down and take our time, and I'm going to go through all the things that I have in front of me. You may or may not have these things. It's really kind of an anything goes, although top coats and merinos are going to wet felt better than core. So
Laura asked how your fiber class went.
The fiber class was awesome. I learned a little something about Zoom that I need to address. I plead the fifth to incriminate myself. But there was a lot to cover, a lot of good questions. So what I'm doing in these group classes, I'm going to sit for a minute, is trying to allow enough time for everyone to say hi and introduce themselves, and then give me a little bit of, you know, what's your question, or what are you looking for, or what are you hoping to learn today, or where are you with the needle felting? So that's really fun because I've done two. I did the armature and the fiber class, and they're both rescheduled along with a selling and pricing class. And we had people from the UK, Australia, Japan, Canada, all over the US. So that is a really special aspect of it.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
The hour and a half format is working really well because we all meet each other. And then I have, for each of these classes, you know, a plan. And I go through that. And along the way, I can check my notes and answer people's questions along the way. And most of the things that people want to know is kind of included in what I plan to talk about. And then at the end, we have time for more questions and just a little bit more discussion or maybe more kind of unique, specific things. So I'm really, really enjoying it. And the horse is considered, there's three sort of terminology. There's this service, which is the one-on-one. There's a class, which is the groups. I've been using 8. And then the horse is called a course. Meaning
okay.
there's a horse course. It's either called a course or a session, but there's multiple things scheduled for that, for what you're paying for. There's multiple dates. They're fixed dates in this case. So it's pretty cool. And we're just at the tip of the iceberg with it. So I'm excited about it. Thank you for asking. That's
cool.
Fun. Yeah.
It looks like several people who have not wet felted before who are here to learn. I am gathering some are watching, some are
okay.
participating, but I assume you're planning on sort of the beginner take on wet felting, but it seems like that would be helpful to people.
Definitely. Yeah.
Okay.
Also on the fiber question, well, it's going to be the same with what we're doing today. Like, there's so much to discuss. So the conversation itself opens up sort of more conversation, which is kind of cool.
I think you have fiber stuck to your right elbow.
I just did get it off, but it's a video delay situation. You're going to see it in a second. I actually pulled it off while we were talking a minute ago.
That's funny.
So what I have today.
Oh, you got it.
Yeah, see? so funny.
Someday I'll see you in person again, my friend.
I have a towel just folded in half under here. If I were being really persnickety, I could maybe put some Gore-Tex or a shower curtain. But generally, especially with this, these are going to be smaller things, not like a great big, huge project. I can keep the water where it's supposed to be. I mainly have merino fibers. And I'll go through this in 1 second. I just wanted to show, this is a snail from a long time ago. All needle felted. The way that we did it when we did the snail project was part of a fiber fairy. So this was all needle felted. The two pieces, the shell and the body, were wrapped on the Zoli tool. So it was pretty simple and fun little project.
It's not a terrible way to do it.
Yeah.
It's good.
This was... What was this? This was the same thing. I just started messing with it the other day. I'm not in love with this one. I don't know. I was kind of playing with colors, and he doesn't have a face yet. So the idea is there's two pieces. The body is kind of like, unfortunately, sort of like tongue-like. It's like a long, you know, tapeworm kind of thing. And then
we had a lot of fun talking about the snail project, if I recall.
It was funny. You should watch it. It was, I don't know where I was, but I was like on a different planet. And the shell The shells come in lots of shapes, but my interpretation is to, whether it was wet felted or needle felted, to make kind of a cone shape. This is flat, but, you know, a 3D cone. And then spiral it. And then kind of the big part of the cone, like this, the big part of the cone sits on the snail's body. Somehow, and it would be have been good if I did a little more research, the snail, like, it goes like a slug along the bottom, but it also must go up into that shell, like a muscle or something. I don't know, maybe you could Google that, Kylo. How does the snail body work? I don't know. So this was wet felted the other day, and I really like it. Like, it is kind of crazy. It's a little weird, but I really like it, and I'm looking forward to making this into something. Oh, she's a snail tattoo. This was wet felted at the same time, and it's a little derpy looking. I've got to figure it out. I was just trying to, like, I was like, I got to make this into something to show them. And I also forgot to put the wire in until the very end. So I, like, shoved it in there, but you can totally feel it. It's really weird. So this would be his head. And this shell would kind of go like that. I kind of like the pink and the orange. It's a fun combo. All right, so that's where I am conceptually.
Somebody asked about what came in the wet felting kit. So as you're showing your setup, you may want to...
Yeah, the wet felting kit has the 30 by 36 inch, I think I'm getting that right, heavy duty blue bubble wrap. It has a 36 inch pool noodle. No, I just got really confused. They're hearing me and seeing me in time, right? You're just not seeing me in time.
I'm hearing you ahead of time.
Right.
Okay. I'm seeing you like everyone else is. Okay. I think I'm the only one on a delay.
Okay. That was
I'm the only one on a video.
It just kind of made my brain weird. Okay, and then a piece of wall that is the same size as your bubble wrap, and it also comes with two, what's it called? It's kind of spandexy ties, but I haven't been using those, so I don't have mine. I don't have mine out here. If you don't have a wet felting kit and you're able to do at least some bubble wrap, you know, from, I know you've been ordering those Amazon packages. Even if you just have it like a cookie sheet or a towel, I think this might be a little too big. Like the very first time I wet felted with Lee and Joyce, we did, we were using, like a Ziploc bag. So, but this might be a little bit too big of a project to fit in there. So hopefully you guys have the minimum. If not, take notes and just enjoy hopefully being here with us and watching how it all works in real time. Okay, so we got a little feedback. The body is mainly in the shell.
Yeah,
and what
looking.
Sticks out is this head and tail.
Up in the shell is the stomach and the kidney and...
Yeah, so does it look like a big T? Like, I'm picturing this, like...
Well, it looks like I feel like an upside-down T, but instead of the T having, like, the tall vertical part, it's, like, more like a ball.
Yeah.
Okay. That's weird.
Okay. Yeah, ew, it's weird. I have two resists here. I think I'm going to use the shell one and not the body one. I don't... the idea of the body being like a big stuffed tube, I think isn't really working for me. So this is a body piece that I wet felted. Partway through wet felting, I did put the resist in and wrap it around, and that's why it has this kind of crease to it. But I opened it back up because I didn't like it, and because I didn't plan to wrap it around the resist, so when I laid it out, I had all this fun stuff on the edge, and I really like that. And so, and sometimes they have this kind of ribbony, weird like edge to their tail slash head body. So I'm going to day two next week, I'm gonna needle felt the body in a coordinating color, probably a pink to go with what's happening here, and just felt it on to there. And then let this stick out.
That's cool.
Yeah. So today I need to make the shell for this one. And so today I am not going to use a body. Goodbye. I am going to do the shell with a resist. If you don't have any resist material, just lay your shell. I know you'll see when we lay it out. Just lay it out in a triangle shape. And then once it's all wet felted, you're going to needle felt a cone, and just like we did on the old school snail, and then you're going to wrap your wet felted piece around it and felt the seam. Totally works either way. Might even be better that way. Maybe we should do it all that way.
I always I'll get confused by the resist, but
yeah.
That's because I have a hard time visualizing where everything's supposed to
I'll
go.
I'll do one with the resist, and I'll do one with that. I'm going to make two shells. Maybe I'll make two shells and two bodies. You guys could do one or two or whatever. This shell resist, which is what I used for the pink baby, my little pink baby, which I love. That's how big. It's pretty big. It ended up pretty big. So it is about 11 inches long. I've got 2.5 at the base, obviously tapering to a point. So 2 inches in the middle, 2.5 at the base. It's a little big. You might want to go more like 10 inches maybe. I'm here to make the mistakes for you. Okay, I'm going to set that aside for the moment and show you my fiber. This maybe will be, what did I have this out for? A body. This maybe will be a body. These are just merinos. This I can set aside.
Someone asked about mohair, asking if that wet felts.
I have a little piece of mohair. I love what mohair does. It makes a little wiggly pattern. So mohair could be fun either kind of going across or down that ribbony edge. This was some merino that was out of one of the fiber art bundles. Like a fiber art bundle would be really fun way to approach the snail because all those pretty colors are in there. So I did some really bright things, so I'm really trying to like get a little more earthy. So that's what this color family is. That's my earthy pile. Then this was going to be one, also pretty earthy. I might kind of mix these two together.
Should the resist be what you want it to end up as far as size if someone's cutting one?
Yeah, exactly. It's just hard to tell what your wrapped up cone. You know, if I go by the snail tutorial, which is a size that I like, this was wrapped on about 8 inches of the Zoli toll. I would make my resist a little longer than 8 inches just because it's not going to stretch as much. So I think that 9 to 11 inch range for the shell is good. So I have what? I always wear the wrong thing. But this sweater has like these sequins on the elbows, and they're just like great big fiber grabbers. Okay, I have some silver sable fur, which is not quite a thing yet, but I want to see how the fur felt. I want to experiment with that. I have some yak silk, which is like super shiny and really pretty, so I thought that would be fun. And then I have a little bit of random silk. I have a hanky, which the hanky in the body is really fun because you get that, that's what was in here, you get that kind of ripply edge.
Uh-huh.
So if you have a hanky, you could spread out in the body. I have some white ones. I just brought all this stuff out. I don't know what I'm actually going to use. I got out some yarn because I thought on the shell, wouldn't it be cool to have like kind of a more bold kind of raised stripe across the shell.
Okay. People are excited about the silver fur and the yak.
Yes. That's because it's super exciting. Okay, so let's start one thing at a time. I'm going to make two bodies. Are you typing or eating?
I'm opening a package of fruit snacks. Because you know me and my gummies.
I'm like, what are you eating? All right, that was going to be a shell, so I'm going to set that aside.
I just made a bad joke, and I'm wondering if the person's going to understand that I'm joking.
What? Oh, did you type it?
Yeah. Mary Powell said she just ordered her first supplies. She's watching, and she's ready to get her feet wet.
Yeah.
And I said, if you get your feet wet, you're using too much water.
That's funny. I think it's a good joke. I don't think it's a bad joke.
Well, do you remember with Talbot? Man, he had a lot of water.
Oh, and then he got upset. Yeah. He did have a lot of water. That was funny. Okay, so let's say I'm going to use a silk hanky in my body. The first thing I want to do is lay out an underbelly. You know me and my aqua.
Oh, yeah. So this is the best color.
And the just like needle felting, when we make a taco and we put that piece across, or, you know, we're making structural shapes, there's a little more structure to it if you can just kind of crisscross your fiber. And whether you're pulling from a roving or from a bat, this takes a little practice, but it's very important. There's a fringy edge at the top, and you want to grab all the way across the fringy edge and pull. And that gives you like this beautiful paint stroke, basically. And that's what you're laying out. In other words, we don't want big random chunks. We want like nice gossamer, even paint strokes. So for the body, I'm going to lay out a rectangle that is about 6x8. And if I'm using a silk hanky, I want a little bit of wool on each side of it. Like sandwich it in there. I also have necks out. So this is on the thin side. I know it's going to get more fiber. It doesn't have to be a perfect up and down, across. I've just kind of let my fringy edges crisscross a little bit. Any questions so far? Oh, Trisha wants aqua. Do we not have a good aqua?
I don't know. I always think Blue Moon, but it's not quite as...
Blue Moon is a little more grayed out, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good recommendation. One of the flower colors is a little bit aqua-y.
Right.
That's coming, but...
What is the blue mat made from?
The bubble wrap?
Yeah, I just think your surface.
Oh, yeah. It's just bubble wrap.
It's like heavy duty.
It's heavy duty, yeah. I got it. It's in my earring. It's stuck to my sweater. Okay, it's in my mouth. Okay, so the idea with the hanky is to get, kind of obliterated this, but to get the edge of it. Which edge is better? The edge of it out to the side. So you get this kind of cool wavy thing. One side has it better than the other. So I think I'm going to go with the idea the way this one was. Which is
what are you using for this base color?
What's that?
How much are you using? Like amounts, I think.
I don't know. I just judge it by
light, just very light.
So it's 6x8 and it was pulling the thin amounts the way I did and crisscrossing them. I don't have a way to say it was, 6 inches of fiber.
But not huge hunks.
No, very, yeah, really important. I'll go over it again. When you pull from your roving or your bat, you just want your hand to grab the fringy edge so that you get really thin, even strokes of fiber. And that's what you lay down. So, I don't know how else to describe it.
People are laughing at you as you struggle with the hankies.
I think I got it.
They always freak me out. They feel like spider webs.
So I'm going to shape this a little bit, kind of pointy at the butt and head. So I'm making a little bit of an almond shape. Just by squishing it together. I feel like it's easier to lay out a rectangle. So then I got to think about what do I want to put on here. I think a little bit of nets would be fun. And then it's going to need a little more wool over it to make everything stick. I wish I could see pictures of what everybody's doing. That'd be fun. I don't think I could get 150 to 200 people in a Zoom chat.
Everybody would be the size of a thumbnail.
I know. Yeah, neps are super cool. So this snail body, I'm really making a little bit more not quite so crazy colors. I feel like I need a little bit of this earthy stuff in the middle. So now I have that wool base, I've got a hanky, I've got some neps, and I'm just going to put a little bit of wool crisscross down the middle. This is more because I want this to be a different color than the edge.
Someone's asking if you can zoom in on it. I don't know that you can really zoom with
the camera. I can't. We're not in tutorial mode here. Although that one controller, which I haven't been able to, I don't know if you remember the
from your computer.
Yeah, I haven't been able to get it to work. It's really weird. Launchpad. What was that? Yeah, the camera setting thing. It's not letting me do anything to it. It's not letting me zoom in or.
Can someone use curly locks and or hand carded, I'm guessing like house carded bats, would they work?
Yeah, the bats would work. Yeah. Locks, yeah, you could put locks in there. It's good. Locks don't felt well, so it's going to be a little bumpy or unpredictable, I guess, is what I'm after.
Well, the best house-carded stuff is going to be some of the flower colors when we get there.
Yeah, yes.
Because they're going to have a little more merino silk, right?
Yeah. So I've got this darker center, and I just need a little bit of wool on the edge. I'm trying to decide what that should be. I could try this silvery. I don't know what this is going to do. This is the yak silk mix, but. It might be a little too linear, or I don't know. With the wet felting, what you see is what you're going to get, so pretty much. So I feel like there's a pretty strong, I'm always blending my colors visually. I don't do like strong stripes. So where the silver meets this earthy color, it's a little strong to me. So I might just put another, try to find the gray area in this fiber and just put a little bit more on here.
If you know which fiber you're using, if you could name what it is, I think people would like that.
I'm saying everything I'm using. This is I used the yak silk mix. This is kind of like a short staple merino out of a fiber art bundle.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. You guys you're going to have different stuff than I do. It's just the way it is in these times. Although now that we're open, we can, you know, do this a little differently and get back to, maybe putting doing a felt along with a certain kit and putting it on sale and all that.
It's definitely taking us longer to get stuff out the door.
Yeah. All right, that's that one. I'm going to leave it at that. I'm just going to try and move it over. All right, that's a body. Let's do, where is everybody?
I don't know.
Snail joke, Kyla.
I know. This is extra pressure. I'm not prepared with all of my things. I'm not in Milo mode. My guess is I use a lot of the snail jokes when we filmed.
I'm sorry I can't zoom. I'll get my settings figured out and see you.
What happens when two snails get into a fight?
What happens when two snails get into a fight? I don't know what.
They slug it out.
That's a good one. This project, someone just said you can use whatever you have. Definitely. Yeah, this is, This is a small amount of fiber. Any of the top coats of merinos will work for you. So it can be any color.
Is it a garden snail? It's a Sarah snail.
It's whatever kind of snail you want it to be. But when I was looking up inspirational pictures, I looked up, I think I looked up land snail is the way that I did it. Okay, I was going to make an earthy shell. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to start with this purple just because it's beautiful. And I'm going to lay out that cone shape. So narrower at the top, getting wider towards the bottom, looking at about 10 inches. So I'm going wider than my resist because I'm either going to be folding it around the resist or I'm going to be folding it around my needle felted core that I do next week.
Someone's having major static electricity thing going on.
Okay. If you have static, get yourself like a sponge or a wet paper towel and just pat your hands on it. Static is basically lack of moisture in the air. So that will help. Okey-dokey. That is pretty. I'm going to put that mohair. Oh my gosh. This is so pretty. I think on my shell, what I did on the pink one was I did silk, and then I did some stripes because when you fold it around itself and then roll it up, it's fun to have those kinds of spirally stripes in the shell, but they're, again, their shells come all different kinds of ways, so. So you could do a really strong, stripe, like with a, with a piece of yarn. Anything will stick.
I just see you looking through lots of things.
Oh. Definitely have my little favorite color family. I can't seem to shake. So I have my initial merino like cone shape, and now I'm putting yarn and mohair in stripes, basically. And now I feel like I want some silk, and then I'll put a little bit of look, I was going to be earthy, and now I'm all
it's
bright again.
Earth-ish.
I wonder if there was any silk in that. How's everybody doing?
I think people are having fun.
Okay. Maybe some chunks.
Does it have to be wool yarn? Ideally, yes.
Wool yarn is good. Wool yarn.
Oh, acrylic is not going to really stick the way you want it to unless it's sandwiched between wool, in which case it would be covered, right?
Right, right. This is the silver fur. I'm letting it overlap my yarn a little bit, and my merino, I'm not being as particular with these stripes. Like, I'm letting them be a little bit of an overlay so that, you know, everything hopefully sticks together. But I would like a little bit of pop in this, and I don't feel like I have it. Maybe that's what the aqua is.
There's questions about the resist. Is it going to go on top of this?
We built this visually to be looking at the top. So what I would do is when we start wet felting, I would get this going, like get it to start to become a skin, and then flip it over. And then if you want to put the resist in it, you would put the resist in, flop the edges over. And if you needed to put a little more fiber on the other side, you could. Sometimes when you work with a resist, it's so big that you lay out your fiber on top of the resist. In other words, the resist would be under here, right? You lay out your fiber all on top of the resist. You start wet felting on this side, then you flip it over. You fold your edges over, then you lay out a whole nother thing on the other side. We do that in the how to felt a vessel tutorial. This is so small, I'm just going to start this side, flip it over, and fold the fiber over the resist, and then felt that fiber, rather than not having to add a whole second. Okay, I'm going to move that out of the way. So just keep plugging away and having fun laying out whatever you're laying out. I'm going to do another body and another shell, I think. Because I want to show as many possibilities, you know, as I can. So this body, I'm going to go light. Oh my gosh, this is going to be so fun to see what everybody makes. I think they want this body to be kind of pink. So I'm going light underneath. And maybe I'll put a white hanky in there.
Does the Firestar Merino felt okay?
Firestar Merino. I don't know what that is. I mean, I know what Firestar is.
That's not Merino, right? Firestar.
Firestar is like a synthetic. So you need to sandwich that. You need to have that between some wool, I would think. I don't think it really felt. But it'd be fun. It would be really fun to put in there. It's just you have to consider that it.
There's There's a request that you use some colors so people can see better. Okay. And how did you do the spots on the pink one?
Oh, on the pink one, I cut up hanky. I just cut it up. But it doesn't have to be hanky. You could cut up any fiber. And actually, on the body, I'll do it on one of these. I'll put some color on this body. On this body, I cut up pink fiber, just like make almost like making a confetti. So I'll do that on this guy. I'm sorry that you guys can't see very well. Use the force, I think. Is that helpful? Okay, I don't have a good point. I'll use this marigold stuff. Oh, I forgot you're on. I was like gonna set my phone away. I would lose you.
You would lose me.
Try this. Let's try blending Smear Gold and this Hush or Sea Mist or whatever this purple is called. Alright, so this is very neutral. It's like I'm actually kind of neutralizing the pink by putting this very heathered light purple into it. And then I'll do a little confetti to show you guys.
Can you wet felt a pipe cleaner into the body?
What just happened? The way we're gonna do this, there's a chance to put the wire into the body next week. So I would not, but I guess you could. I think pipe cleaners are made of steel, which
might rust.
Yeah.
You could definitely use Angelina. That would add sparkle.
Yes. Oh, sparkle would be fun. Okay, what color spots do we want? We could do orange, we could do aqua, I could do sharp. Chartreuse would look a little weird. Yeah, no. Not an option. Aqua? Sure. It's my favorite. Good suggestion. Let's put a little silk in there too and see what happens. Alright, so we've got aqua silk and aqua wool. And I'm just going to use my scissors and mix spots. And this is subtle. You probably can't see it very well. I'll try to hold it. Because it's a similar value to what I've got down here. So this is like the shell of the snail world. It's going to be a little...
Okay, everybody wants your aqua, and from what I see, the shell looks similar to the body as far as dimensions, so there's some questions about, like, where you are with sizing.
Yeah, they are. So, I started the bodies out 6x8, and then I squished them. I squished them into kind of an almond shape. So... By the time I lay everything out, that's measuring more like 5.5x10. But it's not a set thing, you know what I mean? Like, there's opportunity to change it and smush it, and it's going to shrink when you felt it. And when we go to the needle felting part, you can cut, you can brush stuff out. So as long as you're in... that range. This is a purple yarn. But I don't know what's going to happen. You got to have a little bit of that, like, it's okay, I don't know what's going to happen. Isn't that the theme of our lives right now? Not doing so well with it. I'm like preaching something that I'm not even able to do. Ask my sisters. All right, you can see those spots. I think it is a little. The light is a little washed out. I hope you guys do find some fun bits around your supplies that you can play with. How's Amy? Is she on here? Amy was yesterday. She was like going to be kind of scrapping together some leftovers from from kits. I was like, well, what kits?
Unless somebody comments, I don't know.
What kits do you have? Yeah. Okay. I'm scooting body number. I got my two bodies. And one shell. I feel like I should make another shell. We'll start wet dropping. Bright colors, huh?
Yep, that's the request.
That's the request. Here I am trying to get a little more. All right, can I get out of my purple and aqua rut? Let's do this. Let's do this silver, and then I will totally be punching it with colors. So we're gonna have kind of a neutral background. So on my shell piece, just so you guys can see, there's the resist on it. Let me scoot this back so you can see it. So I can see that when I flip it over, it's going to go all the way around, maybe even a little bit too much. But just so you know, it's wide enough that those will flip over it. Purple to match the spot. Brilliant! I like it. I like it when people are figuring out my stuff at the same time that they're trying to figure out their stuff.
Sue said use her llama.
Oh, I do. I will go get that. I will go get that. I'll be right back.
Oh, what happened?
It's a little out of my comfort zone. I think the llama is going to have to be spots. So kind of similar. I got this bright pink silk. So let's do stripes with the bright pink because that would be super awesome. You know what I could have used? Remember that bamboo, what was it called? Bubble gum yarn?
Yeah.
I'm
going to
get that. I'm sorry. I'm getting that. So what's cool is, if this is something you haven't done before, and this idea of the, this might not felt at all. I don't know. This is like, this is completely experimental here. Of the wet felting combined with the needle felting opens up a lot, I feel like. The mermaid's tails were really fun to do using these techniques. The frogs, the doodle bugs. We did the tiger this way. I'm sorry if I sound like a broken record, but it just gives you a lot of potential. You could also like wrap some wool around your finger or a tool and make sort of spots.
I can't wait to see how that felt.
How are we doing on time here? Okay.
But you just go for it, which is good.
Kind of focusing this towards the back center because that's really what's gonna show. Maybe do 5 of these is a good number. Their shells do all kinds of weird things. Like some of them weren't stripy at all. Some of them had spots on them. Some of them just have like kind of like a color change. I probably do need something to hold this pink onto the gray. We'll see how the llama felt. I don't know, Sue, have you done much with it, wet felting? I did use it in that very bright first body and it's remained a little bit fuzzy. So we'll see what happens. I didn't cut it. I used the whole fiber. Maybe this is a thin. I'm gonna put a little more silver on it too. Or like a, I don't know, maybe a weird color.
Should the spots on the body be down the sides? So they would be outside the shell.
Yes. I mean, you could have that. The shell is definitely going to cover a portion of the back of the body. But, you know, spots on the head and tail will still show where the shell is not. So.
Sue said that she's used it, she's had no problem, and cutting it is good.
Cool.
And Emma said that some female moths are wingless, and they look like furry slugs.
Oh my gosh. So crazy.
How is a moth wingless?
Like
what does it do?
It just makes a baby and dies.
Wow, that's something.
Yeah. I'm talking like I know. I saw one show. I saw one show about, it was more about, it was that Night on Earth show.
Okay.
What is this? This is a show. Okay. And it was about the male getting to the female And, like, it took all of his energy. He never has a meal in his life. It's just him getting to the female, and then they mate, and then he plummets to the jungle, you know, floor.
Oh, my gosh. That's crazy. What kind of life is that?
Yeah. Well, he's very beautiful. All right, we're calling this. It's, it looks like a really bad Christmas tree. Oh, gosh. So funny. You guys, we shall see. Could you guys weigh in on if you're ready to wet fuck? Send us a sign. Send us a message.
Someone's asking why the French eat snails.
I am not French. Do not eat.
Oh, you're cleaning up. You're getting ready. Do you need to put something over the silk hanky?
I did. Yes, you do. I did. Did you? All right, I'm going to move these around so that they are properly.
I'm getting mostly readies.
Okay, we'll get it. We'll go. Oh boy, you guys, this is a slippery disaster. Okay. This is not going to fill. Listen.
Would you think about selling hand spun wool yarn?
Yes, we could, we have a little collaboration with a local friend for the Fox kit. Actually, he's not, some of his stuff's hand spun, but he's dyeing, wool yarn. So, it's just expensive. Usually the art yarn or the hand spun, there's not really room for a middle person.
Right.
And I've sold mine, but I haven't been spinning in a year or two, so. But it's out there. That's, you know, definitely check out Etsy and check out, I think the Sheep and Wool, because it was canceled, is putting together a little, you know, sale page. And can I use this?
Something. What's that?
I don't know. It's another yarn that was in my box.
We're having a conversation about eating snails.
Okay. What's the consensus?
They're delicious unless you hate garlic and butter.
it's pretty much a butter and garlic ratio. Butter and garlic to snail ratio. Like some clams, I guess.
Can you explain the hanky, and is there an alternative if you don't have one?
You could use a little silk roving.
I mean, you don't need it. It's just a different texture.
Yeah. So you'll see, you know, these two bodies have them. The two shells do not. So you'll see a little variety of what happens here. I'm really worried that this entire thing is not going to fill. But that's why we're playing around, right? Okay, it's time.
All right.
So I want to put my my voile over my pieces, and that allows me to put a little pressure on them, wet them down without moving, kind of is a little security blanket for the wool.
You made sure that the pieces were far enough apart from each other that they weren't going to melt into each other?
Yeah, I just arranged them to hopefully keep the water where it should be and, not have them melt together. I do not claim to be wet felter, pro, that's for sure. So
it's good. You don't have to be a pro.
Just sharing what I'm doing.
Are you done?
So if you don't have a sprinkler, just try to let your water, you know, fall on your fingers and spatter around a little bit, so it's not, you're not pouring a great big puddle in one place. And then when I do this second bit of sprinkler, I'm gonna use some of my my olive oil soap. This water is, at this point, it's warm, which is fine. It doesn't need to be super hot. And it does have a little bit of Dawn in it already. I have to go get another towel. I'm having an incident.
You're having an incident?
Yeah. Just went like right off this edge here. There we go. And then when you press it down, you can get a feel for if everything's wet. Because if it's not wet, it will still feel poopy. What you doing, Kyla?
Well, I'm helping. Matthew was climbing a wall in the basement. I had to check on him. There you go. Try to get that out without getting paint everywhere, please. Thank you. We're painting an accent wall down in the basement.
Ooh, that's exciting.
Sorry. Okay.
So, at first, my pressure is very gentle. It's very even. I'm not using my fingertips or anything. I'm using the entire palm of my hand. And it's gentle because the fiber is all still, it's just laying there on top of each other. It hasn't become one yet. So you have to start gentle so that you don't squash its hopes and dreams.
Is there a special name for the water sprinkler?
We should have one, shouldn't we?
Well,
we're good at that.
Bonsai sprayer, browser.
Yeah, that's the browser. That's the word I know.
Okay. And someone commented that you were getting your feet wet, which I missed.
I was.
I missed as I was checking on our freshly painted walls.
And if you keep your hands soapy, then it's going to feel real like the part of the idea is, well, the soap helps it felt, but it's going to feel real slippery, and that's good. That lets your hand glide around. Your fiber is going to come up through the wall a little bit, which I always find to be amazing. I don't understand why it does that, but it always does. And at that point, when it's doing that, and when you can start to feel like things aren't as squishy under your fingers, they feel a little more solid under your fingers, that's when you want to try peeling your wool back. And you have to carefully make sure your wool stays on the, stays down, and make sure it's not felting through your wool, which this one sort of was, more so than I'm used to. And I wonder if it's that short merino fiber that I put in there.
Wanted to come through.
Yeah. So I'm holding my wool down. See, this one's lifting off much easier. And I'm just teasing the two things apart, the wool and the wool pieces. So that's good. It's good to take it off, get some of this fiber off of here, But if I were going to use the resist, which I will here, this is a good time because it's not very well felted to flip something over. I mean, it is just started, so you know, it's just holding together enough to flip it over. So I'm gonna put my resist in there, and then I'm gonna flip this fiber over it. And I've even got it going around again. Okay, so now the resist is in there. And I only have one, so I'm only going to use it on one. And I'm going to go a little bit more on this and then flip everything over again. Everybody good out there?
It seems like it.
Yeah.
Conversation
you can,
about the wall.
Yep, you can use tool.
If you don't have wall. Mm-hmm.
You can use like tool or netting or I think pretty much what what you're looking for is that it's a polyester.
Mm-hmm. Anytime I've used tool or netting, I feel like
it gets more stuck.
It's all
to me.
Stuck in it.
Yeah, but it does give you a little more kind of texture that is working against the fiber, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I think when I did the other ones, I don't think I rolled at all.
Oh, really?
But we can roll. I'm going to roll, I guess, because I have so many pieces on here. All right, I'm going to flip these over. Get it the other side a little bit. I really love the way this one with the purple, I know you guys can't see very well, but the way the one with the purple is going. So on your bodies, you could decide if you want to fold any edges or just let them be natural the way that they are. In other words, I could want this line more like. I'll just try it so you guys can see what I'm talking about. I'm just going to fold that edge over so that that line is a little more, a little less amorphous and a little more defined.
That edge of the silk hanky makes the coolest.
I know, it is so cool. It's doing the hummingbird wet felting project is just super fun for that reason, like making those flowers. So now I can feel it's a little squishier on this side because this side hasn't been. I feel like this snail shell is going to look like a Christmas tree, but oh well, we'll see. All right, so once I've done, 10 minutes or so with my hands and I've folded my edges, I've done my resist, I'm, confident everything is where it should be, I can roll it up in the, around the pole noodle. If you don't have that whole thing going on, just keep using your hands. This is, this is going to be fine for this, especially because we don't want it. We're not after like super hard, like I'm making slippers, We're going to further felt this together to the other, you know, to the needle felted part of it. So you actually don't want it like super duper tightly felted. Or if it is, you know, you have a little, you have to undo it a little bit. So I put the pool noodle in at the edge. I'm rolling everything except for the towel. And once that's rolled up, then I use the towel to be my holder. Hold her together.
Don't roll the towel in there. You will suck up all of your water.
Yeah, don't put the towel in the bubble wrap. It'll dry your piece out.
I've done that.
Yeah, your towel gets soaking wet, and then you have to, like, wet your piece all over again. I don't...
And then your towel's wet, so that's no good.
So I'm going to just do this from two edges. It's, like I said, it's not an art piece, so I'm not, like, you know, trying to go super crazy here. I just want it to hold together. Slippers. Mary's asking if we have the slippers. That is totally not my thing. I don't know how to do it. There's people who do it, like, super duper well. So I probably wouldn't spend my time trying to figure that out because other people are already doing it. So
it's been figured out
so very well. I did watch a tutorial on it, and I was completely fascinated. I loved all of the tools, of course, that the person used. And there were quite a few tools involved. Rollers and handheld wet felters. And I'm making quite a mess in here over these weeks. I shouldn't say a mess. I'm making a lot happen in here. That's what I should say. So I'm gonna
Do you count your rolls?
I didn't. You should. So I'm turning it the other way. Check on things. Maybe I'll flip this back over so they be here. So pretty. I'm just flipping things over. Oh, yeah, that's not going to stick. Okay, it's all right. My green snail looks a little lame. I got to plan my bodies to my shells better, because, like, none of these things are coordinating to me. But. Oh, well.
In theory, yes, you should roll the same number of times or the same amount of times so everything shrinks evenly. Especially if you're precise.
I'm not sure what I'm going to do when it comes time to take you guys to the, take this to the sink.
Oh, the sink.
I know. I maybe can switch my video source and then we go together with my laptop. I do not know. I don't know. I'm not sure if I should try to switch my video source midstream here. Next week will be fun. I have an idea for the antennae, and so I'll try to get at least one of my snails completely set so we can see where we're headed. You know, I was thinking about how important visualization is. in life in general, and how part of the problem or the difficulty in teaching a workshop is sharing that visualization of the direction that you're going. And so on the felt alongs, or if you are, we always say to watch the video first before you start. Any time that you can mentally prepare before you jump into something, like, the better, basically. So, like, my field hockey coach used to tell us the night before a game, like, to visualize going after the ball, don't back off, you know, what your shot's going to look like, how you're going to dodge, all this stuff she wanted to, us to play out in our head. Yeah, and you really did go in feeling prepared, or like, I don't know, like you had a plan or you knew what you were doing. And
I think that's a big part of why so many of us feel like we're floating right now, because
we can't,
not an answer, and there's not a, there's necessarily a big plan.
Definitely not a time to plan. Definitely not. And it's very hard to visualize
the
next day, because you kind of, things have been changing so much every day.
Right.
But in terms of needle felting or learning from tutorials, whether they're mine or somebody else's, or I think watching the video, you know, or somehow, or whether you study the animal, like some roadmap makes the process go a little easier, I think.
You'll be more successful and theoretically more comfortable along the way.
Yeah. So
this is labor intensive.
This felt along was a little kind of like, you know, what are we doing? You know, because it doesn't have a... All right, I'm calling this good. I really like this one. It's my favorite. I put tussa along the edges, and it made kind of a really cool edge. Oh, I forgot to say, I should have mentioned, it's best if your resist can kind of be a little overly long and stick out so that the wool doesn't, you know, felt the end of it in. But I was able to pull that apart and pull the resist out. So with soapy hands, when you use the resist, if you want to make this rounder, you just come at the edges a little bit. So just to eliminate that fold of where it was, you know, folded around the resist. Doesn't take much. It was really fun making the vessels, because at this point you kind of like squished it all different ways, like take it and put it the opposite way of the way it was around the resist.
So the Christmas tree one is a shell. I'm kidding, it doesn't look like a Christmas tree.
That's a shell. Oh my god, it does. It's so wacky. Some of the yarn stayed, some of it didn't. Okay, this is a body. This one's a body. This one is a shell, but I did not use the resist. So when it's time to needle felt it, I will make a cone shape out of wool, and then I will tease out the edges, and I will felt it around the cone shape. They're all Christmas trees. They all turned out like Christmas trees. And then this is a body. I don't remember what was going on here. It's okay. It's very earthy. It's very dragon-like. So I think I want to shrink it a little width-wise. So I'm going to roll it up width direction and just roll it a little bit.
Someone's asking, did you want it that small? I'm assuming the one with the resist. I'm not sure. Or the body. I don't know.
They're all pretty big, actually.
Yeah.
So just doing that, shrunk this width-wise. I don't know if you guys could tell. But, okay, I'll just show you. I'm at 3 inches in the middle, okay? It might not do it as much this time because I already did it. This is why we turn the pole noodle, because the direction that you felt it. All right. That's probably about as small as I want to go. Now I'm at 2.5 inches in the middle.
You can definitely see how it's shrinking up that way.
So that's good. Okay, I'm going to leave you guys here because it's just way too awkward to try to bring you to the sink. But all I'm going to do is take my 4 pieces and under very hot water, I'm going to rinse and squeeze them. And you don't have to be careful or gentle. They're staying the way they need to stay right now. And then I'm going to switch to cold water, and then I'm going to switch to hot water, and then I'm going to switch to cold water. So, I leave you with each other and with Kyla. Actually, let me narrow this one up a little bit too. And with your thoughts, your visions, your snail visions. And I'm really looking forward to next week because I think it's really cool. I'm glad we're doing a two-parter, and I'm glad we're doing this kind of weird unknown together. Oh, I like taking the body and doing this because with the idea that the body is just going to get a little bit of, wool in here and then a needle-felted belly. I mean, really, if I stuff the head and taper the tail, I could even leave the body this skinny. Like I wouldn't even necessarily have to put wool in the middle. Okay, I will be right back.
So if you're home and you're having to do yours, you want to go super hot. Squeeze them, then super cold, then hot, then cold. If you have a lot of silk in there, you can also kind of ball them up and smack them against the side of the sink. It does some really neat stuff to the silk. It sort of makes it scrunch up a little bit.
So, did everybody have success?
I'm not sure. You're quick. People are seeing Milo on the floor in that basket.
Oh.
He's just hanging
That's
out.
That's disturbing.
He's been too busy lately.
He's like, eh.
You left me here on your shell phone.
really want to see what everybody made. I'm like, can you put pictures on your... Can they post pictures on YouTube?
I don't think you can post anything in the comment. So anything in the hot and cold water, just you're really wanting to get the soap out?
I'm just running it under the faucet. Hot, yep, getting the soap out. It shocks it. The hot water just opens up the fibers a little bit, and then the cold water snaps them back closed, so it kind of sort of sets in what you've done, I guess. Ironing is fun, if you would like to iron.
Someone was told to do a vinegar wash after the rinse.
Yeah, vinegar sets color, sets... I never have, but you could. This, what did I use? You know, it was that that merino from the fiber art bundle. Is really, really cool. I have to remember that for the dragon class because it's really interesting. So this is my shell. Sans resist. This is the one with the resist, which basically looks like a super wacky gnome hat. I don't know what I'm going to do about the pieces that didn't stick. I might pull them off, or maybe I can arrange it into a way that you're only seeing spots that that it did stick. The silver sable felted well. It's kind of interesting.
Sue said the llama did say hair.
Yeah, the llama on this one, this has a lot of Sue's llama in it. It's that bright turquoise and bright purple, and it is a little hairy. So, you know, maybe not the most snail-like, but it's very pretty. But this is nice and smooth and tight and interesting, and I know you guys can't see super well, but where the silk hanky met the neps, it's doing very natural, kind of interesting things. So I guess I would pair this shell. This is like the party snail. Maybe I mix them up. I don't know. I might have to make some more shells with a little more intention of, you know, what I'm trying to coordinate with here. This one would go with that, I guess. That is definitely a party snail.
Again, if you post pictures on Fanfare, both you and the people who've made theirs, that would be fun to see what
people my gosh,
did.
Yes. I really want to see how you guys did. Oh, good. Somebody, their little confetti worked. That's good. Yay! Good. We've had some success. That makes me so happy. I don't know. I feel like wet felting is such a, so fun because it's kind of freeing. This I like. This was that yarn. This was that hand-dyed yarn. Really felted in there. And the mohair also did a really cool squiggly thing. So that's cool.
If the shell turned out too big...
You don't really know yet because, well, maybe it did. Okay, so maybe your shell is too big. When we go to do the needle felted part, two things. If you use the resist and it's too big, you might have to stuff it. You might have to kind of squeeze it together in a spot, or I don't know. I have to figure out how to address that. But you can, if it's too long, you just, the end gets rolled up. So you hardly see it anyway. So you could just take some off of the end. If it seems too big and it's open and you didn't use a resist, then it's just a matter of overlapping it more to make it the size that you want it to be. So
there's, so the shell is going to get stuffed.
The shell is going to get stuffed. This is stuffed. Okay. Yeah.
And someone's asking which one was the hanky.
This had a green hanky in it. And this one had a white hanky in it. But I folded the edges over, so it's a little
right.
cleaner.
Can they be put in the dryer?
I wouldn't. Just roll it up in a towel. It would dry out. If you're having a sunny day, it'll dry outside in like 20 minutes. The dryer might further shrink it or do something.
And iron can do some neat stuff.
And iron is fun. It makes the silk shine. And it. Oh, I kind of like the pink one. I think the pink has to go with the pink.
Yeah, it looks cool.
Yeah, I think I have to keep my colors together. I think that's what my plan's going to be. So. Okay. Dragon clothes. Yay. Oh, I can't wait to see. Put them on. I'll put some pictures on Fanfare. But I hope you guys will put some pictures on Fanfare because it's really killing me that I can't see what you're doing. So I'm excited, and and we will regroup next week and do some sculpting and construction. This one is a total mess. Oh my gosh, it's so funny. Oh my gosh. So, yay!
Very cool.
Yay. Okay, you guys, let's follow up on Fanfare, and we will see you next week. And if you have any, sometimes we've been having a little bit of like, I can't find this, I can't find that. The posts about felt-alongs, about Fiber Fairy, about what's happening at the shop, about the online classes, they are going, if you go to Serafina Fiber Art page, that's where you can see them without all of the group. You know, if I put something in the group, in other words, it's going to get buried eventually. So that's where to go first to look for a link or information. I'm going to sneeze.
Bless you.
Maybe it's on one.
So anyway, just, yeah, check out there. You can always ask on Fanfare and like 30 people will answer you. More people than you ever wanted to will answer you. Kyla is answering emails at admin@serafinafiberart.com, and we're not answering the phone here. We just we're working one at a time, so we don't have the person power to ship and answer the phone. So, but if you leave a message, we will certainly get back to you. And I've really been enjoying getting to know more people. I've been making some phone calls personally and meeting people in the online classes, and that is a really awesome aspect to the recent changes in situation. So, okay, have a good rest of your weekend, and thanks for being here today.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you, Kyla.
Sure.